she conceived by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have moulded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. Come, let us adore him. Psalm 25. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul, my God, I put my trust in you. Let me not be humiliated, nor let my enemies triumph over me.
Let none who look to you be put to shame. Let the treacherous be disappointed in their schemes.
Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths.
Lead me in your truth and teach me. For you are the God of my salvation. In you have I trusted all the day long.
Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love, for they are from everlasting.
Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord.
Gracious and upright is the Lord. Therefore he teaches sinners in his way.
He guides the humble in doing right, and teaches his way to the lowly.
All the paths of the Lord are love and faithfulness to those who keep his covenant and his testimonies.
For your name's sake, O Lord, forgive my sin, for it is great.
Who are they that fear the Lord? You will teach them the way that they should choose.
They shall dwell in prosperity, and their offspring shall inherit the land.
The Lord is a friend to those who fear him, and will show them his covenant.
My eyes are ever looking to the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet out of the net.
Turn to me and have pity on me, for I am left alone and in misery.
The sorrows of my heart have increased. Bring me out of my troubles.
Look upon my adversity and misery, and forgive me all my sin.
Look upon my enemies, for they are many, and they bear a violent hatred against me.
Protect my life and deliver me. Let me not be put to shame, for I have trusted in you.
Let integrity and uprightness preserve me, for my hope has been in you.
Deliver Israel out of all his troubles. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The book of Deuteronomy, the 4th chapter, beginning at the 9th verse. Moses undertook to explain the law, saying, Only take care and watch yourselves closely, so as neither to forget the things that your eyes have seen, nor to let them slip from your mind all the days of your life. Make them known to your children, your children's children, how you once stood before the Lord your God at Horeb, when the Lord said to me, "Assemble the people for me, and I will let them hear my words, so that they may learn to fear me as long as they live on the earth, and may teach their children so." You approached and stood at the foot of the mountain, while the mountain was blazing up to the very heavens, shrouded in dark clouds. Then the Lord spoke to you out of the fire. You heard the sound of words, but saw no form. It was only a voice. He declared to you his covenant, which he charged you to observe, that is, the Ten Commandments, and he wrote them on two stone tablets. And the Lord charged me at that time to teach you statutes and ordinances for you to observe in the land that you're about to cross into to enter. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Song of Moses. I will sing to the Lord for his lofty outlet. The horse and its rider has entered into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him. The God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. Yahweh is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army have been into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. Fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious and mighty. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the hosts? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and worker of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand, the earth swallowed them up. With your constant love you led the people you redeemed. With your might you brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and on the mount of your possession, the resting place you made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The beginning of the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and Timothy our brother, to the Church of God that is in Corinth, including all the saints throughout Achaia. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation, who consoles us in all our affliction, so that we may be able to console those who are in any affliction with the consolation with which we ourselves are consoled by God. For just as the sufferings of Christ are abundant for us, so also our consolation is abundant through Christ. If we are being afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation. If we are being consoled, it is for your consolation, which you experience when you patiently endure the same sufferings that we also are suffering. Our hope for you is unshaken, for we know that as you share in our sufferings, so also you share in our consolation. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, of the affliction we experienced in Asia, for we were so utterly, unbearably crushed that we despaired of life itself. Indeed, we felt that we had received the sentence of death, so that we would rely not on ourselves, but on God who raises the dead. He who rescued us from so deadly a peril will continue to rescue us. On him we have set our hope that he will rescue us again, as you also join in helping us by your prayers, so that many will give thanks on our behalf for the blessing granted us through the prayers of many. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A song of God's children. The law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus
has set us free from the law of sin and death. All who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For we have received the Spirit that enables us to cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness that we are children of God. And if God's children, then heirs of God. If heirs of God, then fellow heirs with Christ, since we suffer with him now, that we may be glorified with him. These sufferings that we now endure are not worth comparing to the glory that shall be revealed. For the creation waits with eager longing
Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world. For only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care, and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known among us, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O Lord, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that the course of this world may be peaceably governed by your providence, and that your church may joyfully serve you in confidence and serenity. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you as eternal life and to serve you as perfect freedom, defend us, your humble servants, in all sorts of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defence, may not fear the power of any adversaries, through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
O God, almighty and everlasting Father, you brought us in safety to this kingdom. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we may not fall into sin, nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do this day, direct us in the fulfilling of your purpose, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by your Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified. Receive our supplications and prayers, which you offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their several vocations and ministries they may truly and divinely serve you, through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore.
Amen.
Today is Memorial Day, a solemn day in the American calendar. We remember all those who have fallen in warfare, both civilian and military. This afternoon on our YouTube channel at 3:11 p.m. we broadcast a memorial act of commemoration for Memorial Day, but that can be joined at any time of the day from 11 a.m.